First-person shooters are one of the most popular genres in gaming. With the release of Ballistic Mode, creators now have access to the official first-person device. What's up? Ice to see you back for another video. Today we'll be going over the official first-person device. If you're new to the channel, please leave a follow, but other than that, let's jump straight into the video. So within Fortnite Creative and UEFN, we now have the official Fortnite device. Go into your content drawer, go to devices, and you should see it right at the top. If it's not at the top of the screen, you can go to new, or you can just search it up in the menu. Pull this device out, place it anywhere on your island, and there you go. You have first person, it's that easy. But since this is device therapy, I will go into some of the settings to help you understand what they do. So within the first person camera, you have the ability to preview what the POV looks like. Obviously you won't be able to see it right away, but if you go into any weapon that's actually available to use first person, like the ones that they use in ballistic mode, you'll be able to see first person. There are weapons that are made specifically for the first person device. If you want to know where those are, go to the very bottom, and right here on the side it says Fortnite Ballistic. These are the most optimized weapons for the ballistic mode, but majority of the weapons are usable in first person. They just don't have their full animations done. Priority. So all the cameras in the game have a priority system. Whatever is the highest priority, that camera is going to be the active camera for any of the cameras. So if you have one that's a cinematic and then one that's a first person, whatever's higher is going to be the camera that the players get first. Affected teams, affected classes are just the classes that this device will get put on no matter what. You can also invert it so everybody but these classes will have first person. Obviously you can enable and disable as you can do with every device, as well as the settings that's in the functions. Remove on elimination. That's pretty obvious. You know what happens there. Add to player on start. This setting needs to be on if you want the first person device to immediately snap on to the player from the beginning of the game. If not, you can add it through mechanics. It's on by default, so you don't have to worry about too much. Preview device color. This, you could just change the color of what the device is. It's not necessarily an important thing, but hey, if you want to color code each team with the cameras and everything like that, this will help you organize it a lot better. So transition in and transition out. Priority time. These are how long it takes for the device to actually connect to their first person. You can pick, you know, how you want to enter the camera. I would say work with those, test those out, try them out. You know, they work differently for each of them, so it's cool to try. I am a zombie creator, so obviously I have to have a first person down state, which if you haven't seen that video, it's up here in the corner. Go check it out. It's very helpful and it looks very good. For you to transition from first person down to the crawling first person, you might not want to just go immediately down. You can do that, but you can use the transition in, transition out to make that seem a little bit more seamless because those are two different devices. Look at focus on target. Whatever the target that's closest to you, whether it's a car, an enemy, a zombie, this will focus your attention that way. I think this is a way to make first person Deadshot, which could be really cool, but I will see once I test it a little bit more. Field of view. Now, if you want FOV sliders, like this is really close. Like you see very small FOV versus a very far FOV, this would be the thing that you would use. It might be cool to actually have a FOV slider menu where you can like pick, okay, do you want close, do you want far, but the device that where it's at already is pretty good. So the interaction radius is just how close can you interact with buttons or pick up things. You have it from close, standard, which is like the regular Fortnite. Far is gives you a little bit more ability to reach, you know, a quite bit further. I think standard is good. Close makes it feel a little bit more realistic, but it is very close to you. You have to be almost on the whatever you're trying to interact with for that to work. Yeah. Targeting reticle. The reticle is just the dot you see there, or like the little star, the little dot, whatever. You can have that on or you can turn it off. With no reticle feels more like official, more Call of Duty like. Go for something like this if you're doing zombies or if you're making something a little bit more realistic. Different things you can use, but I would say experiment, always experiment with every device you use. Now, within the functions, you have the option to add to player on an event. So set up some mechanics, maybe a player counter, maybe a mutator zone that connects it if you don't connect it immediately on the game. You can remove camera. You can add to all, which makes it easy, so you don't have to actually just go one by one to add it to people. You could just click that, add it to everybody all at once. Remove from all, same thing. And then focus on target. These just focus your attention on the closest target, closest player that is near you. And that is it for today's video. What is the next device you would like for me to cover? Make sure you like, subscribe, and join the Discord down below, as well as use code FROZENARMY, no spaces in the item shop. Hope you have a nice day. I'll see you in the next video. Peace!